3 of x is 14.6. Here we are asked to draw 147 degree and construct its bisector. Again, as I have told you, bi means 2 and sector means division. So I am going to divide this 47 degree angle into 2 equal parts. Okay, same here. I will draw right angle. Now, right angle should be clear to you. Most of the time now, if you there is some question, right angle will be written in the exam. So right angle is always of 90 degree. Right angle means 90 degree angle. Again, I have to draw its bisector. So I will divide 90 degree in 2 parts. So both questions are quite similar. As you can see here, I have drawn one ray and I am going to mark 147 on the left corner. As I have told you, if I am drawing the angle on the left corner, then I will use inner angles. Now, if you see here, I need 147. This is the starting of inner angle 0, 10, 20, 90, and here is 140. Now, I need 147. These markings are given here in between. Okay, so between 140 and 150, 147 will lie. Now, if 147 I need, I will count 7 lines after 140. This is the dark line for 145. So, I will take 2 further lines for 147. So, second line after this dark line. This is showing me 145, 46 and 47. So, this will give me the location for 147. I am looking for inner angles here. So, let us draw 147. I will keep my D here on the dot and then I will mark 147. Here it lies. Okay. And then I will join it. And I have got 147 degrees angle. So here 147 is drawn with D. Now I am going to bisect it. So for that I will draw a semicircular arc and this arc meets 0 degree and 147 degree angle at 2 points and these I am marking with dots here. So from these 2 dots I will draw further 2 arcs in order to find the bisector. So if your angle is more than 90 degree you may need to open your compass a little more. So I am going to open it. You can also open it according to your comfort. So here I have opened so that my 2 arcs lie outside this circle. Okay. So here I have drawn 2 arcs. Okay. So where these 2 arcs cut each other, that point I will join with the vertex and here I have got the bisector for this complete angle. This complete angle is divided into 2 equal parts now. Okay. So I can mark here. A, O, B, C, I can write any name as the name is not mentioned. And these 2 angles will be equal now. A, O, C, this smaller angle will be equal to another smaller angle, C, O, B. So these 2 angles are equal. Angle A, O, C is equal to C, O, B. And these are half of 147 degrees. Okay. And half is 73.5. Done. Next is right angle. First of all, I will draw 90 degree angle. So, as I am going to see inner angles, but 90 degree is same for inner and outer angles both. It is having the same value, same place. Okay. For inner also and outer also. It will be giving me same place. Okay. So, let us mark for 90 degree. I will match this line with the edge of this D and I will keep my arrow on this dot and here is the arc for 90 degrees. Now I'm going to join it and here angle 90 degree is drawn. Now I'm going to bisect it. So for bisection, first of all I will draw a semicircular arc and from these two intersections where this arc is meeting the baseline and 90 degree line where I am going to draw these 2 dots, first dot and second dot. I will draw further 2 arcs first arc and second arc. Now I can join it, and when I join, I get the bisection for 90 degree angle. So 90 degree angle is now divided into two equal parts. This part is equal to this part. Okay, so I can name it according to my choice, AOBC. I have written here. So this smaller angle AOC is now equal to another smaller angle COB. AOC is equal to COB, and these both are half of 90. That means 45 degrees. Thank you.